Hello everyone, today we will be going to discuss the semiconductor devices and basic electronic system.
Myself Harshal Dandagawal from KK Work College. I am presenting here the semiconductor diodes and circuits. First, semiconductor techniques have become an independent branch in the field of electronics. The solid-state electronic devices have revolutionized the world of electronics due to the lightweight, small in size, high efficiency, and great life expectancy. However, it has some limitations and disadvantages, as well like the temperature dependency of characteristic, higher inherent open noise, and operational frequency limitations. The semiconductor substance, those electrical conductivity which is lies between the conductor and insulator. Without the semiconductor in the world, nothing is possible. Everything is depend upon the semiconductor. Today we use the different types of gadgets, electronic instruments. It is basically depend upon the semiconductor components. So let us see, in the first year BSc computer science syllabus, the paper 1 title is Semiconductor Devices and Basic Electronic System. The objective of this course to study the various type of semiconductor devices. Second one, to study the elementary electronics and system. In this paper 1, there is the 6 unit. The first one unit is the semiconductor diodes, the different types of diode. Then next one is the BJT. BJT stand for the bipolar junction transistor. Third one unit is MOSFET. MOSFET stand for metal oxide field effect transistor. Fourth one unit is power supply. Fifth unit is the oscillator, and 6th unit is data converter. Now let us see one by one. Today we will be going to discuss the unit number 1, semiconductor diodes. In the semiconductor diode, first thing we will be going to overlook about what is meant by the semiconductor, the p-type of semiconductor, n-type of semiconductor, then the formation of the p-n junction diode, then what is the working principle of a p-n junction diode in the forward bias characteristic and reverse bias characteristic, Zener diode, the working principle. Next one is the LED, photodiode, optocoupler, and the solar cell. First one thing is semiconductor. What is meant by the semiconductor? A semiconductor are those metal who behave like an insulator at 0 degrees Celsius and could be the conductor as a room temperature. Or a semiconductor are those component who possess the both type of property, the conductor as well as insulator. Here the silicon and germanium, the atomic number is 14 and 32, both is act as semiconductor. In the outermost shell of this silicon, it is a 2, 8, 4. The outermost shell is a 4, and in the germanium the atomic number is 32, 2, 8, 18, and 4. It is a 4 electron is in there. It is easy to donate and get the electron from any another atom. So that's why these both are act as a semiconductor. The semiconductor, these are majorly two type. One is known as intrinsic semiconductor, another one is known as a extrinsic semiconductor. A pure form of the semiconductor is known as a intrinsic semiconductor. Germanium and silicon both are in pure form. When the impurity is present in the semiconductor, this is known as extrinsic semiconductor. Which kind of impurity? The n type of impurity and p type of impurity. The fifth group element like phosphorus, arsenic, asbestos, these are the material which is added into the semiconductor. This is known as the n-type of impurity. A trivalent impurity like that aluminium, gallium, indium, which is added into the semiconductor, is known as extrinsic type of semiconductor. What is meant by doping? The process of adding the impurity is known as doping. The p-type of doping, when the holes are majority charge carrier, then this is known as a p-type doping. If the n-type of doping, here the electrons are majority charge carrier according to the periodic. In the extrinsic semiconductor, we use the group third element, and the p-type of doping we use the fifth group element. In the periodic table, here the group third element like aluminium, gallium, indium, the atomic number is 13, 31, and this one 51. Next it is the silicon, germanium, arsenic, then next one is the phosphorus, arsenic, and asbestos. These are the material. Now let us see the first one semiconductor component is known as a diode. A diode, it is the two terminal, diode is a two terminal single junction device which is a conducting in only one direction. Here this is known as anode, this is known as cathode. Here silver ring is indicate the cathode. It is a physical appearance of our diode. Different types of diode available in the market. All are familiar with this one component. It is known as LED. LED stands for light emitting diode. It is useful in the number of places like a traffic light, then number of display which is a present in mall, offices, railway station, then aeroplane, which acts as an indicator. Then 7-segment display, the LED is also used. Then other also diode is available like a PN diode, step recovery diode, Zener diode, Schottky diode, Varector diode, photo diode, laser diode, tunnel diode, and gun diode. The number of number of type of diode which is available in the market and their different application. Out of that, in our syllabus we will be going to discuss the rectifying diode, Zener diode, LED, photo diode, solar cell, and the application, it is the optocoupler. Then construction, there are the four major method of the construction. One is the ground junction, alloy junction, diffuse junction, and IM implementation. In today we will be going to discuss the alloy junction. In the alloy junction, the germanium as a n type of material and indium is a p type of material, both are combined to each other and both are heated up to the 400 to 500 degrees Celsius. After the heating, it gets liquidified. After the liquidifying, the solidification takes place. Then formation of the PN junction is takes place. The P type material and N type of material is like that way. Here electrons are majority charge carrier. Here holes are majority charge carrier. During the process of formation of this P and N region, the sum of electron which is the spread into the P region and the holes which is the P region is the spread into the N region. This will look like in this way. Here electron which is present here at that place, these are combined with the hole, it forms the ion which is a positive charge ion which is situated near the junction. Similar way, the hole which is present in the P type, this will be moved into the N type and which is situated near the junction. This process, it will be going on continue until when no one electron ion, this will be allowed, the holes move from the P side to the N side and electron from the N side to the P side to this positive ion. This stage is reached, this is known as the depletion region. The potential across the depletion region is known as a barrier potential. Here the surface which is a separate the P and N region is known as a metallurgical junction. So this is overall about this formation of a PN junction diode. Now let us see the working principle of a rectifying diode, the forward biasing. What is mean by forward biasing? If the positive terminal battery is connected to the anode and negative terminal battery is connected to the cathode, is known as a forward biasing. In the reverse biasing, negative terminal battery is connected to the anode and positive terminal battery is connected to the cathode of a diode, is known as a reverse biasing. What happened in the forward biasing? During the forward bias condition, the positive charge ion, it is providing the energy to these positive ions, and negative battery terminal is connected to this negative terminal of diode, so they are pushing this electron to the break this barrier. If the slightly voltage it will be increases, the potential at which the barrier potential is, it may be varies, and then the freely electron hole are combined to each other and the large amount of current is flowing into there. According to this IV characteristic, the third one quadrant, the current, it will be rises sharply. Up to that point, the voltage it will be increases, but it is less than the barrier potential, though no current is increasing to the diode. The potential at which the barrier potential is break and current is increases suddenly, this is known as new voltage. So this is the forward characteristic. What happened in the reverse bias characteristic? In this reverse biasing, these are the holes which is attract to the negative terminal battery and electron which is attract to the positive terminal battery. Due to that's why the minority charge of current which is flowing into the reverse bias condition, this is a minority charge current is flowing into there. Due to the sum of electron which are not recombined with this hole which is situated at that place, this will be moved to the opposite terminal of battery of a positive. During the motion, they are strike or dislocate this ion pair. Due to the dislocating, the electron hole pair both are separate to each other. These separated electron hole pair both are getting the velocity and which is move again the in opposite direction. They again collapse the another ion, and due to that's why the sharp reverse current is increases. This sharp reverse current increasing, this is known as a breakdown potential. This is known as breakdown potential or breakdown current. Then the next one thing is in there, the sum of parameter. It is already we have discussed the new voltage. What is meant by PIV? PIV stands for the peak inverse voltage. The maximum reverse biasing voltage we can apply to the diode without breakdown condition. This is known as a peak inverse voltage. What is the breakdown voltage? In the reverse bias condition, due to the dislocation of electron, the large amount of reverse biasing current is flowing into there, or the sharp reverse biasing current is flowing into there. This is known as a breakdown voltage. What is the application of rectifying diode? A rectifier means what? AC to DC converter. There are the three types of rectifier: half wave, full wave, bridge, as well as it is useful in the wave shaping circuit, clipping and clamping circuit. Okay, so this is the this is our diode. The forward characteristic is the third first one quadrant, and reverse characteristic is the third one quadrant. This is the power supply which is connected to this resistor. The positive terminal is connected to the positive, negative terminal of battery is connected to the negative terminal of the diode. Now in this condition, if we increases the voltage slightly, the voltage from A to B, the diode is offering the resistance. It is a 20 to 25 ohm resistance. And if the voltage is greater than the barrier potential voltage, then the current is increases suddenly from B to C point. This is voltage is known as the new voltage. In this condition, the potential across that point, it is the 2 to 3 ohm only. That means in the forward bias condition, diode offering the less amount of resistance. So this is the about IV characteristic of diode of forward bias. In this case, the silicon is offering the barrier potential 0.6 and germanium is 0.3. In the reverse bias characteristic, the negative terminal is connected to the positive terminal of battery, and negative of the diode is connected to the positive of the power supply. If the reverse voltage, it will be increases. Due to that's why the barrier potential is increasing. Barrier potential is increasing, and due to the minority charge carrier, the current is increases slightly. Due to the dislocation of the electron, the current is increases sharply. Already we have discussed this thing. So this is the you have getting the better understanding how the diode its work in the forward bias characteristic and reverse bias characteristic. It is operate in the reverse bias characteristic in the third one quadrant.
Okay, we have discussed up to this terms and application. Now next one, the specification of a diode. In this diode, there is the different types of diode available in the market. The reverse voltage and current rating, 4001, it is the 50 volt reverse rating. Current rating is 1 ampere. 4002, it is 100, it is 1. 4003 is 200, it is 1. 4004, it is 300, it is 1. 4007, it is 550, it is 1. And by 126 is a 1650, and it is the one is the current rating. Now next one thing is a Zener diode. A Zener diode, it is the PN junction heavily doped diode. This is a circuit symbol. It is anode, it is a cathode, and this is the negative of a Zener. Now let us see the working principle of a Zener diode. Before going to see the working principle, let us see the first one is Zener effect and Zener breakdown. Due to the heavily doped PN junction diode, it is a connected or it is useful in the reverse bias condition. A Zener diode, there are the lot of application. In this case, due to the as shown in the figure, the energy band become across to relatively low voltage. That is the N side of conduction band appear to the opposite to the P side of a valence band. This creates the large number of empty state in the N side conduction band and correspondingly many fill state in the P side of a valence band as shown in the diagram. Now in the Zener diode, the barrier separating by these two band is very narrow. Hence the tunneling of electron from this valence band to the conduction band is a takes place. Due to the reverse thing is happening, the electron is flow from the P side to the N side is a takes place. Due to this battery terminal, this reverse current is flowing into there. This is known as Zener effect. Due to the reverse biasing, this tunneling distance is going on decreases. It is easy to move the electron from valence band to the conduction band is increases, and that's why the reverse current is increases sharply. This is known as Zener breakdown voltage. This is actually a circuit diagram. In this case, the battery supply is connected, rheostat is connected to the ammeter. This is a Zener diode. Voltage will be calculated through this using voltmeter, and this ammeter to calculate the current. This is the IV characteristic of a Zener diode. Here, during the forward bias condition, it behaves like a rectifying diode characteristic. But in the reverse bias characteristic, up to the 80%, it shows the Zener effect. And onwards, if the reverse biasing voltage is increases, then the tunneling distance is going on decreasing and easy to move the electron from the P side to the N side is increases and the potential is breakdown. This is known as a Zener breakdown voltage. Now, what is the application of Zener? Zener is act as voltage regulator. It is act as comparator. It is also useful in the wave shaping circuit. Then, what is the specification parameter? The specification parameter for the Zener, it is Zener voltage and 1.4 watt rating. Now, next one component is LED. LED stand for light emitting diode. All of you aware about that. Here, it is act as anode. It is act as cathode. This is a positive terminal. This is a negative terminal. The type of LED. These are the different types of color which is emitting. Here, this actually construction of LED. The positive terminal is big one and negative terminal is a smaller one. If both terminal are the same, here the positive terminal is look like a peak and the negative terminal is look like a flat in shape. Okay, now let us see the working principle of LED. Why the LED is emitting the light? LED, it is a constructed by using the semiconductor material like a silicon, germanium with the combination of will be gallium and arsenic. A pure form of semiconductor. When the electron from the higher energy state to the lower energy state, the energy is released in the form of heat. But the component gallium arsenide, gallium phosphide, such type of material which is used into there, due to that's why when the electron fall from the higher energy state to the lower energy state, the energy is released in the form of light. This is the working principle of LED. Now, in this case, the gallium phosphate which is emitting the dark red color of light, the wavelength is 910 nanometer. Gallium arsenide, which is emitting the green color of light, their wavelength is 560 nanometer. The silicon carbide, their wavelength is yellow region. Okay, now what is the specification parameter? The current rating up to the 10 ampere to the 15 milliampere. The voltage rating is 2 to 5 volt, and the 330. Current limiting resistance is required to for the protection purpose. So this is the IV characteristic of LED. Mostly the LED is operated above the 2 volt to the 2.5 volt. This is IV characteristic, current forward current versus forward voltage. Then what is the application of LED? LED is useful for the number of places. It is useful in the 7 segment, which is useful to indicate the digital display or digital watches, then 7 segment display, then traffic light control, then number of type of display. 7 segment, these are two types, common anode and common cathode. It is also useful, LED is also useful in the bank, offices, railway station and number of places. Now next one is PIN diode or photodiode. A photodiode which is also operate in the reverse bias condition. A photodiode, the circuit symbol, it is similar like a rectifying diode, only the arrow to collecting the rays of light. This is the transparent plate.
which is connected in the reverse bias condition. When the light energy or solar energy is fall into there, the electron on hole pair are dislocated, and due to the dislocating, the opposite they will be flowing in the opposite terminal of battery, and due to that's why the reverse leakage current is flowing into the air. In the PN photodiode, conductivity is increases if we dope the one terminal is lightly dope and another is heavily dope, then the PN junction diode the current is increases in the reverse bias condition. Similar way, the another one type is the PIN photodiode. The material we can use the indium gallium arsenide or indium phosphide. Here the intrinsic material which is put into the P and N region, which is a sandwich between them. Due to the open glass package, when the light ray is fall into there, due to the ion creation, the reverse current is flowing into there. Due to the PIN photodiode, the current is increases highly. This is the IV characteristic. If the distance of the source and the photodiode increases, the current conduction, the current at the output, it will be going on decreases. So this is the IV characteristic of a PIN photodiode. What is the application? It is useful in the optocoupler, remote controller, character recognition, burglar alarm, etc. Then what is the optocoupler? Optocoupler is providing the isolation between the two circuit. It is consisting the pair of two things. One is known as LED and another one is photodiode or phototransistor. Okay. It provides the isolation between the two circuit. Like that, the first one circuit is connected to the LED, second one circuit is connected to the phototransistor. So it provides the isolation. The type of will be optocoupler, or example of optocoupler is MC2 or MC2E. Okay. What is the application of optocoupler? It provides the isolation between the two circuits. Then ground looping or block voltage spike. And the last one part is a solar cell. All of you know that solar cell. What is the working principle of solar cell? The photovoltaic effect. What is the photovoltaic effect? The sun energy is converted into the electrical form of energy. This is known as the photovoltaic effect. This is the circuit symbol of a solar cell. Here, open circuit voltage, the infinite load is connected to this input side terminal. The voltage between the terminal when the current is drawn, the infinite load resistance. The short circuit current, the current when the terminal are connected to each other, the load resistance. The short circuit current is increases with the light intensity, as the higher light intensity means the more photon, which in the turn mean the more electron. Since the short circuit current is roughly proportional to the area of solar cell, the efficiency of solar cell can be defined as the electrical power to the output divided by the incident light intensity. How to decide the specification of solar cell? It is depend upon the fill factor, form factor, then their IV characteristic. The solar cell, it is useful in the UPS, water heater, traffic light control. There are the many applications of the solar cell. Thank you all of you.